So, ASP.NET Core versus Java Spring Boot. This was a surprisingly difficult comparison to make. While I was doing my research on ASP.NET Core versus Java Spring Boot, I came across several somewhat worryingly strong opinions on the topic. For what it's worth, I think it's always a good idea as people who work long hours, mostly indoors, to touch grass and breathe in some fresh air once in a while. Living like Nosferatu, you know, surfacing once every 24 hours only to feed at night, then straight back down to the basement to pound out more and more mind-bending code is probably not a healthy way to live. I think balance is the key. Speaking of Nosferatu, have any of you seen the new Nosferatu movie? If you have, please let me know in the comments section your thoughts on Nosferatu. And please no spoilers, I'm debating whether or not to see it myself. So this is a challenging topic. Not whether or not to see Nosferatu, I mean ASP.NET Core versus Java Spring Boot. It really seems to come down to two excellent technologies that are both great choices for developing enterprise-based web applications. And I'm trying to use my hands more when I talk. It's good for emphasis, I think. So, it's quite a tough choice. ASP.NET Core versus Java Spring Boot. Which one ultimately wins? Let's find out. You probably already know which one I think wins. Please let me know in the comments section which one of these awesome technologies you think is the better one out of the two, ASP.NET Core or Java Spring Boot. Please also let me know your reasons for your choice. So let's first briefly look at a basic overview of Java Spring Boot, and then we'll look at a brief overview of ASP.NET Core. Java Spring Boot is a framework designed to simplify the development of Java-based applications. The Spring framework, created by Rod Johnson in 2002, addressed complexities in Java Enterprise Edition, J2EE, development. It gained popularity for its lightweight and modular approach. As Spring projects grew in complexity, developers faced challenges with configuration and deployment. There was a demand for a streamlined solution for building and deploying Spring applications. Pivotal Software released Spring Boot in April 2014 to simplify Spring application development. It introduced auto-configuration to reduce manual setup, embedded servers, Tomcat, Jetty, for easier deployment, opinionated defaults for rapid development. Spring Boot gained rapid popularity due to its ease of use, becoming the go-to framework for microservices development. Spring Boot integrated seamlessly with Spring Cloud, supporting scalable microservice architectures and cloud-native development. Spring Boot 2.x 2018 introduced improvements in reactive programming and performance. Spring Boot 3.0 2022 shifted to Java 17 Plus and Jakarta EE9, emphasizing modern Java standards. Spring Boot continues to evolve, focusing on simplifying modern Java application development for cloud-native and microservice-based architectures. Right, let's look at an overview of ASP.NET Core. ASP.NET Core is a modern, open-source web framework developed by Microsoft for building cross-platform web applications. Microsoft introduced ASP.NET in 2002 as part of the .NET framework to build dynamic web applications. It evolved over the years with technologies like Web Forms, MVC, and Web API. However, it was Windows only and had limitations in scalability and flexibility. As web development trends shifted toward open source cross-platform solutions, Microsoft recognized the need to modernize ASP.NET for better performance, flexibility, and platform independence. In June 2016, Microsoft released ASP.NET Core 1.0. It was a complete redesign of ASP.NET with these key features: cross-platform support, Windows, Linux, macOS, modular architecture with NuGet-based components, unified framework for MVC and Web API, built-in dependency injection and middleware pipeline, cloud-ready and lightweight. ASP.NET Core 2.0 in 2017 simplified development with the meta package microsoft.aspnetcore.all and Razor Pages for page-focused development. ASP.NET Core 2.2 in 2018 enhanced performance, support for health checks, and Signal R for real-time communication. ASP.NET Core was fully integrated with .NET Core 3.0, enabling desktop and web development in a unified platform. It introduced support for Blazor, WebAssembly and server-side, and gRPC. .NET 5. In 2020, Microsoft unified the .NET ecosystem, merging .NET Core and the traditional .NET framework. ASP.NET Core became the standard for web development. .NET 6 in 2021 introduced minimal APIs, performance boosts, and long-term support, LTS. .NET 7 in 2022 and .NET 8 in 2023 continued performance improvements, enhanced cloud-native support, and expanded Blazor capabilities. ASP.NET Core today is a leading framework for building high-performance, scalable, and cloud-ready web applications across multiple platforms. If you like this video so far, please hit that like button. If you haven't yet subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel, and please don't forget to ring the bell. Please share this video with anyone you feel may benefit from its content. If you'd like to thank me by buying me a coffee, you can do that at my Buy Me a Coffee webpage at this URL. It will of course be greatly appreciated. I love reading your comments, so please feel free to engage with me in the comments section. Which of these technologies do you prefer and why? All comments are of course welcome. Your insights are always greatly appreciated. It would be great if you followed me on X. My username is @GavinLonDigital. Right, let's consume some delicious comparative details on the topic of ASP.NET Core versus Java Spring Boot. Runtime platform. Spring Boot runs on the Java Virtual Machine, JVM, making it cross-platform. ASP.NET Core runs on the .NET environment, which is also cross-platform, Windows, Linux, macOS. Programming language. Spring Boot uses Java, also supports Kotlin and Groovy. ASP.NET Core uses C#, also supports F# and VB.NET. Web server integration. Spring Boot uses embedded servers like Tomcat, Jetty, or Undertow. ASP.NET Core uses Kestrel as the default server with optional integration with IIS on Windows. Performance. Spring Boot is known for its high performance, but may have slower startup times due to the JVM. ASP.NET Core is generally faster and more efficient with lower memory usage thanks to lightweight design and ahead-of-time compilation, AOT compilation. Deployment. Spring Boot deploys as jar, war files, and these jar or war files can be deployed inside Docker containers. ASP.NET Core can be deployed as self-contained executables or also inside Docker containers. Configuration. Spring Boot uses application.properties or YAML files for configuration. ASP.NET Core uses appsettings.json files, environment variables, and command line arguments. Development tools. Spring Boot commonly uses IntelliJ IDEA, Eclipse, or Spring Tool Suite, STS. ASP.NET Core leverages Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code, and the .NET CLI. Dependency Injection, DI. Spring Boot has built-in powerful DI via the Spring IOC container. ASP.NET Core has a native, lightweight dependency injection system built into the framework. Ecosystem and libraries. Spring Boot has a large ecosystem via Spring Projects, Spring Security, Spring Data, etc. ASP.NET Core has a rich .NET ecosystem with exclusive libraries through NuGet. Cloud integration. Spring Boot is cloud agnostic with support through Spring Cloud, AWS, GCP, and Azure. ASP.NET Core has deep integration with Microsoft Azure and cloud-native tools. Please note that ASP.NET Core applications can also be deployed on AWS and other cloud platforms due to their cross-platform and cloud-native design. Licensing and support. Spring Boot is open source under the Apache 2.0 license with community and enterprise support, VMware. ASP.NET Core is open source under the .NET Foundation with strong Microsoft support. Learning curve. Spring Boot has a steeper learning curve due to complex configurations and annotations. ASP.NET Core is simpler to learn, especially for developers familiar with Microsoft technologies. Summary. Spring Boot is often cited as best for complex enterprise-grade applications and being cloud agnostic. ASP.NET Core is often cited as better for high-performance web applications and has tight integration with Azure and Microsoft's ecosystem. ASP.NET Core can, of course, be easily deployed on other cloud platforms like AWS or Google Cloud. Okay, so which one wins, ASP.NET Core or Java Spring Boot? As always, when comparing two top-tier technologies, the answer as to which one is better is not usually cut and dry.
You're tearing me apart!
Your company may already be, for example, heavily invested in Java skills, in which case it makes sense to build, for example, your next enterprise-grade application using Java Spring Boot. If, however, your company is already heavily invested in the .NET ecosystem and therefore .NET skills, well, you want to stick with your C# and .NET skills. It doesn't make sense to move to Java Spring Boot for your next enterprise-grade application. You as an individual aspiring developer may wish to work in an area where Java is prevalent, and you are more likely to get a job as a Java developer. So you will definitely want to invest your time in learning Java. Of course, the converse may be true for other aspiring developers where C# skills are more in demand in the area in which you may wish to work, in which case it will make sense to invest your time in learning C# and perhaps ASP.NET Core. Perhaps salary is your main criteria, in which case you'll need to research which of these technologies pays more in the area in which you wish to work. You may just like the look of C# over Java or Java over C#. My personal preference is C# and ASP.NET Core. I've worked with both technologies, Java Spring Boot and ASP.NET Core, and far prefer the .NET ecosystem in general. It is easier to learn and the ecosystem is far less bloated. Of course, you can't go wrong going down the Java route, but C# and ASP.NET Core is my personal choice. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please let me know in the comments section which one of these two technologies you prefer and why. Your insights are always greatly appreciated. If you liked this video, please hit that like button. If you haven't yet subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel and please don't forget to ring the bell. Please share this video with anyone you feel may benefit from its content. If you'd like to thank me by buying me a coffee, you can do that at my Buy Me a Coffee webpage at this URL. It will of course be greatly appreciated. I love reading your comments, so please feel free to engage with me in the comments section. All comments are of course welcome. Your insights are always greatly appreciated. But I'd love to know which one of these technologies you prefer and why. It would be great if you followed me on X. My username is @GavinLonDigital. I hope to see you soon. Thank you and take care. The Spring Framework, created by Rod Johnson in 2002, addressed complexities in Java Enterprise Edition J22E. Spring Boot integrated seamless. So when doing your research, it is important to